Before we get into today's video, take a look at this picture. You'll have to excuse the relatively low resolution. It's from a preview for a book that was released today, Star Wars Book of Lists. Do you notice what's wrong? Well, keep that in your mind because I think that it's important. I want to talk about this book and how it represents a major, major problem in how Star Wars is handling the quality of its published materials. But before we get into everything, I just want to say that I've got a more standard Eckhart's Ladder upload for today on the second channel as consolation. It's basically about the real Star Wars Legends starfighter tactics and strategies you'll want to try to employ in Star Wars Squadrons. As another note, I'll also be donating 100% of the revenue from today's video to community member Fractal Sponge, and let's talk about why. So when I first saw this image, like I think a few of you watching this video, the first thing that I noticed was not in fact that all of the vehicles in the top right hand corner are mislabeled. It looks to me like some intern or somebody was going through the book without a real knowledge of Star Wars and was basically placing these labels on ground vehicles. The ATTE is identified as an MTT, while the MTT is identified as an AAT, and the AAT as the ATTE. Now that's a lot of letters. Shit happens. It's poor quality control. I get it. It's a bit of a tangent. I do think it is a major issue that we're getting these books pumped out that just aren't really very good. I had to buy this book to ensure that the mistakes I'm talking about in this video weren't actually solely present in the preview images, but actually made their way into publication. And they did. So before recording, I read most of the book, which is actually pretty long, but not full of a whole lot of substance. It's mostly just screens from a movie and different parts of the Star Wars universe fit into a list type book. There's 100 different lists. For example, this one is about armored heavy vehicles. There's another about holograms, for instance. Because of the breadth of the book, the actual content is very sparse. I will say, with the exception of the ending, which talks about some of the out of universe stuff about the filming of the Star Wars movies, that's actually pretty cool. But I feel like there have been a million of these books that have come out under Disney or one of the various publishers, and I'd like to see more quality reference books and different sources, like we had with Star Wars Legends. So far, I would say that these books have catered quite significantly to the more casual fan, with notably some exceptions. The Rebel Files book, for example, was pretty good, despite the fact that there were literal Empire at War modded assets stole, which is just bizarre, and it was passed off as new artwork for Star Wars. But another example of just lazy publishing has come with the Ultimate Star Wars books. We're getting really off topic, so I'm not going to go too far into these, but they've basically sold us the same book like a dozen times or now. Even the author, Ryder Windham, had this to say, and unfortunately I don't have a screenshot of the original post, but he said, "What would the holiday shopping season be without yet another revised and expanded edition of a Star Wars book that I worked on years ago, but haven't earned a dime from since?" But no, quality control isn't the issue here. The main problem that I saw right away was the fact that Star Wars is, once again, using a Fractal Sponge model for free without getting permission. Now, a lot of you guys know who Fractal Sponge is. He is a very well-known modeler in the Star Wars community. He made the designs for many of your guys' favorite dreadnoughts, including the Assertor and the Bellator, and just generally, he's one of, if not the very best, ship modelers in the Star Wars fandom, and his work has actually in the past been purchased by Lucasfilm or various publishers for official use, and the main time that I know of anyway is when The Essential Guide to Warfare came out. His ship models, and actually specifically renders, were actually purchased and included in the book with credit. So not only was his work there, but his designs became canon for several ships. But that scenario is really the rarity among Star Wars work. Fractal Sponge has had his work stolen countless times, and we've seen that once again today, specifically with his very, very high quality Juggernaut model. And we actually talked about this not too long ago. The back cover for FFG's Collapse of the Republic sourcebook actually stole his Juggernaut model in three different positions, which is pretty impressive. Not only that, but the Y-Wing model was also stolen, and you guys can find that video where I talk about this more in depth. However, the thing about this case is the theft is just so blatant. Usually when someone takes one of Fractal Sponge's models, they'll at least put some sort of filter on it, or partially obscure it behind other ships, make it look like the scenery, but no, in this case, they just took it as is and removed the black background, which is nice, I guess, that they even did that. And it's pretty funny, I'll show you guys what it looks like reading it on my Kindle app for PC. It really just shows how blatantly lazy this entire process is. We'll come back to lazy in a second because how they frame the use of artwork in this book at the end is really just terrible. But before we do, I just want to address something that I've seen talked about a lot in the comments of these art theft videos, and that's the basic idea that if you're recreating something or modeling something that exists in Star Wars, you have no protection for your art, and if Star Wars wants to take it, well, that's the risk that you take in working with an established IP. And morally, I just do not agree with this. Legally, there may be points. I'm a lawyer, but I'm not a copyright lawyer. I don't know the specifics. I think Disney could probably argue in favor of themselves pretty persuasively. But this is a moral issue as much as a legal one, and there is absolutely no reason not to pay artists who are making this highly detailed, very impressive artwork. I mean, the reason why Fractal Sponge's models are used so much is because they're at the same quality as stuff you see in official merchandising and packaging and whatever else. It generally far surpasses ship artwork that we see most of the time. It comes up with new designs. It's not just the same Star Destroyer or the same still from Battlefront 2 or the movies or whatever else that this book uses otherwise. So if you want Fractal Sponge's artwork, pay him to make it for you. At the very least, and this would still be greasy, at the very least acknowledge where you got the artwork from, because this is really high quality stuff. And in case you guys are wondering, well, maybe they did reach out to Fractal Sponge. No, I messaged him before I made this video, and of course they didn't. And he was shocked, as I was, about the fact that they're getting even more blatant and that the copying is getting even more egregious now. I get it, having 100 lists means you have to get a lot of photos, but that's still no excuse. If you can't do the job right, then just don't do it. So let's look at the very end of the book. All images in this book have been reproduced with the knowledge and prior consent of the artist concerned. No, they haven't. And no responsibilities accepted by publisher, producer, or printer for any infringement or copyright or otherwise arising from the contents of this publication. Well, that's not really how this works. If you steal someone's work, then you violate their copyright. You don't get to write a sentence that says otherwise. Every effort has been made to ensure that credits accurately comply with information supplied. I don't see a whole lot of credits throughout this book. We apologize for any inaccuracies that may have occurred and will resolve inaccuracies or missing information in a subsequent reprinting of the book. So it's like they pretty much know they've done a shitty job sourcing out the artists who made everything for this book, and they haven't even really done an effort of doing so. So their suggestion is just let us know and we'll include a little thing at the end of the material. Well, no. Why don't you pay the artists who are making art for your book? The only art credits I see is for Scott Richardson for design, for Sue Boylan for cover design, for Meredith Mennett for editorial, and for Tom Miller for production, then finally for Shutterstock, and none of those names are Fractal Sponge. So Lucasfilm, all the publishers working with Star Wars, and whoever is managing all of these books that are coming out and stealing fan art, and that includes comics and basically everything with the Star Wars name on it, just do better. This is getting worse, this is getting more blatant, and I'm not going to shut up about it until more people start paying attention, and eventually this will be a big thing, so let's just do better. Just hire Fractal Sponge maybe, or commission some of his work, or just get a database of models that you actually own. At some point, there was a really high quality juggernaut made for Rogue One. There's gotta be a way to easily get that in the hands of the people who need them. But also just generally stop making crappy books. I mean, the quality here is just so bad. MTT Transport. I guess that's a multi-troop transport. And then we got the ATTE, which just apparently doesn't stand for anything. And the Armored Assault Tank, where we get to actually learn what that stands for. So that's cool. Let's do better. And until next time, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll include a link to Fractal Sponge's website and his Discord down in the description. I'm also going to include a link where you can donate to him directly, but again, 100% of the money made on this this video will be going to Fractal Sponge. If you want more ordinary content, just a reminder that we do have that Starfighter video up on X2. Till next time, guys, this has been Eckhart's Ladder. Have a good one, and may the Force be with you.